Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we'll try to understand predefined or library functions and user-defined functions in C. So the concept of user-defined functions, how to declare a function and whenever a function is declared and that function has to be defined. So all those concepts has been clearly explained in our previous videos about the functions. So if you haven't watched those videos, please watch those videos and come back here. And every video in our channel is going to be a part of entire course or a playlist. Our suggestion is to follow the entire course so that you can have better understanding of the concepts, and the link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Now we will try to understand about the concept of a predefined function or a library function. So what is this? Predefined functions are already defined in C compiler system libraries. The definitions of the predefined functions are written in the header files. Example, printf, scanf, sqrt, square root, strlen, string length. So we haven't used about this square root and string length. So we will try to understand about these functions in our later videos. So at this point of time, so far we have covered about printf and scanf. They are also called as functions, but they are predefined functions. Why they are predefined functions? We are using these functions called printf and scanf, but have we defined that function? We are just using it, but have we defined it? No. Where it has been defined? Without defining how we are able to print and how we are able to scan from the keyboards. So they are already defined. Who has defined it? The programmer who has written the compiler. So they are defined in the C compiler system libraries. So system libraries means the programming part of the compiler. In the programming part of the compiler, those functionalities has been defined. So and those functionalities are defined or written in header files. And those functionalities are written in header files. Okay, so what is that header file? And what about user defined functions? And I think there is no need to explain about user defined functions. In our previous classes, whatever the functions that we have defined, functions which are defined by the user are called as user defined functions. These are the kind of functions that we have seen in our previous videos. Okay, so now what is that header file? So far in our discussion, we haven't never ever discussed about this line of code. So what this line of code indicates, this is what we call it as header file, stdio.h. stdio stands for standard input output functionalities. In order to get, so what kind of functions are these? Printf and scanf, they are input functions, and scanf is an input function, and printf is an output function. So the standard input output functions, the functionalities of standard input output functions are written in this header file. That is the reason why it is .h. As it is header file, the extension is .h. It is a header file, and including, this is a preprocessor directive, include this header file. So in this program, the program which is written for printf and scanf and all the different types of input output, standard input output functionalities has been written, and that file will get included. Try to understand that point. So the file which is the programs which are related to printf, scanf will get involved, will get loaded into this program by using this, by including this header file. For example, if you want to do square root of a number, so that square root of a number will not be there in this standard stdio.h. it will be there in math.h header file. So far we haven't used it, math.h header file. For example, if you take string length, it is string.h. String.h, all the functionalities of the strings will be involved in the string.h header file. Okay, so this is what we call it as including the header files. Okay, so now Now, and we have also seen that every function will have a return value. Return 0, int main means that main function is going to return an integer. If sum of function is used, it means it is we are going to return float value. So whenever we define it, we are going to give it as float sum, and in the end we are going to give return some float value. X is a float, for example, float X is there means, and we want to return this X means this, we are going to return a floating point value. We are going to return, this function is going to return a floating point value. Similarly, what about this printf and scanf? What the printf and scanf will return? They will also return something, right? So what they are going to return? They will return, so if you take printf, the number of characters that are printed, that value will get returned. Here we have assigned this printf function. So what happens is this printf will be printed, hello world will get printed, and the return value of this function is the number of characters that has been printed. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and new line is also character. So 13 characters, maybe one or two numbers go wrong. So 13 characters will get printed, and this 13, it is going to return the number of characters, which is an integer. And this value will get assigned to I. If you print I, it is going to print 13, the number of characters that has been printed. Okay, that value will get printed. For example, if you take this, here the value of X is equal to 30, and I is assigned with this printf function, and it is legal. Printf functions can be assigned to integer variables because it is returning int value. It is returning integer value. What is that integer value? The number of characters that has been printed. See here. Here, 1, 2, 3, space is also character, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, sorry, 13, this space, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. And here, we are trying to print X. What is the value stored in X? Two characters, 18, 19, 20, and this new line is 21. So this entire string, this entire printf is going to return 21 characters, and this will 21 will get assigned to I. If you print it, it is going to give the value as 21. Similarly, what is the return value of scanf? Let's try to understand that also. So we'll take another example. See this example. So what the scanf will return? Scanf will return the number of successful scanned elements. So after scanning, how many inputs are successfully scanned? In this case, we are going to scan two elements. So this is going to return two, and this two will get assigned to I. If you print I, it is going to print two. Okay, this is how the printf and scanf will return the values. So let's execute these programs on our compiler and see the outputs. So whether we are getting the same output or not. Okay, here is our compiler. See, all the three programs I have taken, hello world, and it is I. So what it has to print is the number of characters. First it will print hello world, and after that it is going to give the number of characters that has been printed. It is 13. Okay. Similarly, if you take second one, we have to get 21. 21, see here, 21 characters has been printed. And if you take this scanf, we will scan two elements. So it is waiting for us to give the values. I have given 10 and 20, and then I pressed enter. So it has given the output as 2. It means successfully two values has been scanned. Okay, so those the two has been given as the output. Okay, so this is all about predefined functions or library functions and user defined functions. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubt in the comment section below. And if you feel that this video is helpful to you, please give us a like symbol and please share this video with your friends so that they will also get benefited. Thanks for watching.